Hello everybody and a very warm welcome back to Tiny North Eastern and another episode of me messing around on the railway. And I've just come up here and it's really peaceful and quiet, and sometimes you need that so you can concentrate on what you want to do next. And so what we're going to do next is we're going to look at Jarrow Road, because there's been something missing in Jarrow Road for a long time now, and I'm surprised that no one has mentioned it before. It doesn't have a train. It doesn't have a scheduled stopping train, which I have now sorted out. And we're going to have a quick look at what I've done, because it was not captured on film, but I can show you what I have done anyway. So let's go and have a look. Right, so this is the train for Jarrow Road. As you can see, we've got two suburban coaches. Both of these are break ends. This one is Eastern Region and the other one is Midland Region, which it doesn't really matter that much to me if they're mixed. I bought them both together from the famous website of Rails of Sheffield, and I paid just under 30 quid for them, for the two. They are Backman, the old type Backman. I've had to do a little bit of modification work to them. I've changed the couplings either ends, and I've had to do a little bit of modification work to the couplings in the middle. So let me show you what I've done here. So this is what I've done to bring the coaches closer together. and also to stop them uncoupling at Jarrow Road, because at Jarrow Road I have one of those Pico uncouplers set into the tracks, and every time I pull the train out I used to leave one coach behind. But these couplings do not uncouple using those Pico uncouplers. These are what you find on the Hornby Suburban sets. I'm not sure what these are called, but I know they're flat bottomed, as you can see on this one here, and they just, there's nothing there to hang down to enable to separate these. So this rake will become a permanent rake. They'll just keep going backwards from forwards to Jarrow Road and back. So yeah, what I've actually done is, I don't know if you can see closely, you can see the pins there used to hold the old type couplings, and these are the couplings that we took off. As you can see, you've got the three holes there which linked up with the three holes there and there. So we've removed them and put in a NEM pocket there. That NEM pocket socket there, see, which I've just super glued in place in the middle of the chassis, as it were. And this is what they are. They're 103651s. I'm not sure where I got these from, but that's what I have used for there. And then I just pushed in these couplings which you normally find on the Hornby sets, and that works a treat. It just stops them coming apart. And this is the type of Pico uncoupler that those coaches were coming apart on, and now it doesn't happen. I'm still going to leave the uncoupler in place, because we'll still be able to uncouple the engine from the coaches, and so it still becomes automatic over at Jarrow Road. And here is a back-to-back wheel setting tool, which I used to reset the wheels, because I was having trouble with the wheels not being the correct dimensions. So I've had to do reset the back-to-backs on them. But apart from that, they run perfectly now. You've probably noticed I've done a little bit of work on the buffers. I painted them silver and then scruffied them up with some black oil, which you normally see on these buffers stops. So I've done that. And yeah, these will be good to go for another run out to Jarrow Road. Right, so the next job I'm going to do is to look at detailing the inside of this signal box. Yeah, it's quite an old signal box. These were produced in 2016. It's a Hornby Skaledale signal box. I think they used to call it the Granite. When I bought it, it was green, all this framework was green, and I painted it red to give it that north eastern look, or LNER look. And I'm on the lookout for another one, so hopefully I'll get another one for the other end of the station. So let's take this off the layout. Here we are back at the bench with the signal box. I'm just looking at it, and these walls are quite thick on the signal box. Yeah, 6mm thick. I was right, it is a Hornby Hobbies signal box, 2016. These were made, and you don't see a lot more of these around. I've got to be really, really careful with how I handle it, because the steps are very, very delicate. Obviously, we've got no access at the top, so you can't lift the lid off, so everything that goes into the signal box is going to come in through the floor. So what I'm going to do is, I'm not going to go through the kit that I'm going to use, because I've already done this on another video. But this is it, the signal box interior. It's a Medcalf kit. So all I'll be taking you through is how I'm going to fit the kit into the signal box, so that you guys, if you've got a signal box like this, you need to put the kit in from the base. You might need to, well, pay attention to the video. If not, you can fast forward to the next segment of the video. So, right, the first thing I want to do is work out the height of the flooring from the base of the signal box. So we'll say 6 millimeters down from the window. So we use that ledge as a guide. So 36 mil up from the base of the signal box is where the floor is going to be. So what we'll do, we'll take some basic measurements. I'll just make a note of that 36 millimeters. So what I'll do is, when I push the base in, I will go around with a rule and set the base at 36 minus the thickness of the card that I'm going to use to push up into the signal box. So that will then become 34 millimeters. So I shall make a note of that. And the next thing I want to do is measure the base for the width. So as you can see, this, it's not very straight, so I'm going to have to cut the card to suit that shape of the base. It's funny that, because no matter what signal box I do, they're all individual. Right, so that's 40 millimeters wide. And there, and on the length. So if I cut a square bit and then just manipulate the card to make it fit, that should work. So that's 77.5 millimeters. Right, so I shall cut the card. Right, so I've cut the floor, and I've cut a notch there to go around the cables. And what I'll do is, I'll do one trial fit now, and then that's it, because I don't want to keep taking this piece of card in and out, because it might get stuck permanently. So I've just got to round off a couple of these corners, and we'll push it in up to the 36 millimeters, or was it 34 millimeters, and then pull it out, and then we can do put the kit on and then push it back in. So we'll just take a little bit off the corners, round the corners over a little bit. Now, as you've noticed, the building is not square edged, but the card is. But I'm not too worried about that. So I'll just trim off these corners, and hopefully that should fit in there tightly. And then we can make up the kit and try this in. So it is quite a tight fit. There it goes. But what we haven't took in account for, do the walls bend that way or that way as the card's going in? So I'll just push that in a bit further to make sure it will go. I think it will. It looks like it will. Yeah, it will. Now, what we'll do to pull it back is to get a thin bit of wire these and see if we can pull the card back. But we won't be able to do this once all the bits is on there, I don't think. So we're going to have to be a little bit more careful when we are fitting the floor. It's not going to be easy. And we're not even at the right height yet. That's only 25mm. So we've got a little bit more thinking to do on this. Front wall here bends in as you go further off. I just put this ruler on, you can see it's rocking. Not a lot. So that's causing an issue. And obviously I've still got to get around that cable, so I'll just take a little bit more out for that. And hopefully that should be it. So he says. So as you can see, I'm scribing the card. So this is the top side of the floor. And I'll just paint this a very light brown to represent floorboards. And also what I'll do to give this floor just a little bit more strength so that it doesn't buckle when I'm pushing the floor home, I'll glue some lollipop sticks on the back, just two pieces, and that hopefully will keep the floor square as I'm trying to push the card home. So we know it fits and we know it's a tight fit, so we're just gonna have to see how it works out. So moving along quite nicely with this kit, and I thought I'd like to show you a few of these little details that I've not seen before in a kit. Like, for instance, rugs. In the ratio kits you don't get anything like rugs. So this is going to be the first time I've put a rug into a signal box. And you get some posters as well, which is they're very good and they will come in handy for other job. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put a rug in the signal box as well. So progress so far, as you can see, I've got all my little bits slowly coming together, and I've already put in the stove, as it were, but I'm not using the stovepipe because you see that cable runs right underneath or behind the stove and then carries on with the stovepipe. So all those years ago when I put this cable in, I was already thinking ahead for how I was gonna do this. So that stove where it is set at 34mm, hopefully that'll give us something to push the floor up against as we come to add the floor later on. So yeah, I just thought I'd show you those little bits and pieces and a little bit of a progress report before we finish the signal box. The kit is finished, so all I'm doing now is just the finishing touches, painting up the levers with some silver paint, and then we can put it into the signal box. I've added some lollipop sticks to the underside to give it some strength for when we do start pushing this into the signal box, and hopefully that will stop the base of this floor from twisting and bending so that the floor goes into the signal box nice and even. Right, so here it is. I do like this Metcalf kit because you get the rugs and you get some other little bits and pieces. So yeah, I mean, the ratio kit is still far superior, but it swings it around about. So I mean, you pay £6 for this kit, and I think it is worth the money. But yeah, so that is ready to go into the signal box. Now for the moment of truth, will it fit? I'm not going to put any glue around it just yet. I'm going to push it into the signal box and then put the glue in afterwards, once I'm happy with the way that it fits. So I shall now start to push that into the signal box. Hopefully it will go in equally and evenly. Just pushing it as we go. It's got to go in quite a long way. It's quite tight to start with. Ooh. Right, so do you remember earlier on in the video there was that little hump on this wall? So we've gone over that by the feels of it, so I'm just pushing in this corner here gently and gently, and we shall see if we've got that 32 millimeters. Now we've only got 25, so we've got another 5 more millimeters to go before we hit that stove that's in there. It's getting close to the windows. Yeah, we're almost there. Tighten that corner. Good thing about this card is it's soft around the edges, which does help. So we've got 23 millimeters there, 25 there. So the floor is a little bit lopsided at the moment, merely in that corner. 24, 24, 26. So it just needs a little bit more in this corner. Pushing firmly, but not overzealous, because that's a tight spot there. I can feel it. It's a tight spot. Ooh, there you go, that's gone. I have to pull that back out. Ooh. Right, I might have to pull that back out a little bit. So, we need a little bit of wire. And we shall pull that back out a little bit. I managed to get the wire behind the lollipop stick in that corner and then pull it towards me. So I've pulled it back and the floor now is sitting reasonably level. And it's at 32 millimeters. So I think we're almost there. So it's 32 there, 32 there. I think it's 32 millimeters all the way around. Yeah, so I think I could get away with leaving it at that, because as you look in to the signal box, you can see old matey boy there standing. And it's all roughly at the right height, as you can see. Right, I've added some Yoo-hoo glue now, so there's a strip of Yoo-hoo glue in there running across this wall, and I've done the same down in there, across there. I think that's all it needs, because it is quite a tight fit, as you've seen. So there's only one thing left to do, and that's just to add a little bit of weathering along this bottom edge. Something I didn't do when I first painted this signal box. some in there. Wherever there's a ledge, there's dirt. And that is looking a lot better. Now from this distance, we can see something inside of the signal box. So let's have a closer look without clouting any of the signals nearby. So as you can see, if we go through the windows, we can see the desk, the chair, stove. So now we can see that the floor has come right up against the stove, which is good. And there's the pipe leading outside. And if we come round, we can see Tom, and we can see the levers through there and the rocking chair at the back. So yeah, although the detail is not extensive, as it were, there is something in there now. And even from this distance you can see that there is somebody in the signal box. And from one little job to another, what we have here is a Bedford ambulance. I used to have one of these when I was a kid, and Mrs. T bought me this for Christmas, and I think I'm going to have to wire it up and put it somewhere on the layout. We've got a really big road along here heading towards South Shields Station, so I could put it here, as it's quite handy for the electrics underneath. So we might do that, or knowing me, I might change my mind and put it somewhere else. Right, so I'm just doing the finishing touches to this ambulance, because I've had to put a new supply in underneath the baseboard to allow for this additional lighting feature of the ambulance. So I'd just like to give a shout out to Graham over at Woodhill Park Model Railway, because last week he did a video where he cleaned up his station and used one of these. Now my old Hoover has packed up, and this little thing is a beaut. It not only does it suck up the messes, and just watch this. As you can see, you can hoover around figures without sucking them up, so poor old Mrs. Benteen won't end up in the hoover this time. So a big thank you to Graham over at Woodhill Park Model Railway, because he told me where to get these hoovers from, and they're not that expensive. Mine was £15, and it's well worth it. As for my old Hoover, well, that packed up. And that old Hoover of mine was about 15-year-old. So it did well. So I shall now fit the cables in to the new terminal block that I've put in underneath the baseboard, and finish off this video, I think. So that's the LED flashing away quite nicely, as it's now connected up. And I'd like to have a go myself, so this fire engine could be a project for another day. Right, so getting back to this vacuum cleaner, if you type in into your word search, mini vac, and you should be able to find one of these. They're at one of the big websites. They've got quite a few to choose from, and yeah, so good luck with that, everybody. And yeah, the great thing about these is the bristles on the end, so you can hoover around figures and they won't get sucked up. Right, so back to the running session. In the meantime, I'll let you guys sit back and enjoy the return trip back to Jarrow Road. Thanks again for watching. Bye for now. Bye.